So today was a crazy day in the Apple world. MacBook Pro 16 was announced. Tons of hands-on and first impression videos have hit YouTube. But I started noticing a trend on Twitter. A lot of my colleagues and tech enthusiasts in general started posting screenshots of the MacBook Pro 16 they ordered. And in those screenshots were i9 variants of the MacBook Pro. Apple offers three different SKUs of the MacBook Pro. You have the i7 with a 6-core processor. Then there's the i9 with 8 cores, but with two different speed variants. There's the 2.3 gigahertz base, the 4.8 boost, which is the entry level i9, or you can spend 240 extra Canadian dollars and get 2.4 gigahertz base with a 5 gigahertz boost. The problem is a lot of these people were ordering the more expensive 5 gigahertz boost. And the unfortunate part is they're never going to see the speed advantages from it, because these laptops are not capable of boosting that high for a very long time. Let me give you an example. This is a 2018 MacBook Pro. This also has an i9. And right now, as you can see here, the core clock speed is at 1.5 gigahertz. It's not doing much, so there's no need for the processor to ramp up. So it's trying to keep this laptop as quiet and cool as possible. CPU temps are around 50 degrees, so everything seems nice and normal. Now, when I run an application that utilizes all cores, like Adobe Premiere, Final Cut, or in this case, Blender, all of a sudden you're gonna see it boost up to its full potential, which is around 4.8, and then look how fast it drops down. It dropped down literally within seconds. Right now, the frequency is at 3.1 gigahertz, which is not even close to the 5 gigahertz or 4.8 gigahertz boost clock that these MacBooks come with. The most you're going to get when the CPU is 100% utilized is around 2.8 to 3.2 gigahertz. Anything more than that is gonna cause this laptop to get way too hot. You can see right now, the package temperature of the CPU is at 100 degrees Celsius. Now granted, the MacBook Pro 16 is supposed to have better cooling, so you should expect a little bit better of performance. The point I'm trying to make is, and this goes for not just the MacBook Pro, but any laptop with a dedicated GPU and an H-series processor in a form factor that's this thin or close to being thin, you'll never see the true advantages of those boost clocks. It's impossible for these laptops to take advantage of that speed for more than a few seconds. I think for most people out there, if you want the i9, it's fantastic. You're getting 2 more cores. So if you're doing multi-threaded applications, those 2 cores will make a big difference. But if you think that extra 200 megahertz you'd get from the more expensive model is gonna make any difference at all, unfortunately, it's not. Save that money, put it towards more storage or even a more beefier GPU. There's 3 different GPU options, and that might be more advantageous than a processor that has higher clock speeds that you'll never be able to take advantage of. Anyways, think of this as a public service announcement. I ordered a MacBook Pro 16 myself. Once I get it in the studio, I'll be doing a hands-on and full review. So if you have any questions for it, let me know in the comments down below. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.